This is the story of an everyday object, a broom. But it's not any old broom. This is the story of the Besom broom. The history of the Besom is a long one, and apart from sweeping floors, there are many tales of it being used as aerial transport for witches. It was also used in pagan wedding ceremonies. There are some that say that the Besom contains magical properties. Well, this is the magic of the wildwood.
All my brooms are made out of locally cut birch in the winter and left to dry in season. They're going to be tied today with willow withies. These have all been on soak for 3 to 4 hours just to make them supple.
Welcome to the wildwood, Adam. Okay. Seems a long time since I ever made a broom. So how long have you been making Besom brooms?
I've been making them approximately 35 years now.
So who are your customers these days, Adam?
Well, obviously you've got the gardeners who use them as a very effective tool for sweeping the lawn and driveways, etc. Then there's people who buy them for hand fasting ceremonies, which is sort of pagan weddings. And then there's people who buy them for sort of the spiritual side, the Wiccans and the mystics of this world.
And has Harry Potter had any influence at all?
It has, not as much as it used to now, but I still sell Firebolts and Nimbus 2000.
I also remember that Johnny Cottrell used quite a lot of heather, and obviously it depends on the area you're living as to what materials you can use.
When the heather makes a softer broom, I find it the heather's better for sort of driveways, patios, but not so good on the lawn. They use hazel for the handles to grow nice and straight with no knot. This tool is a rounded draw knife. It's sharpened on the outside and it's used for taking the bark off round poles. The next task is to put the handle into the head, which the pointed end will go in the end of the head. And then I'll turn it upside down, hit it on the chopping block, and the head will slide down the handle. The next step is to put a peg in through the middle of the handle. That will then stop the handle from twisting or moving up and down, and therefore locks it in place. Right, perfect, not too thick, nice point on the end. That's right through the handle. I'm going to take this out. And there we have a finished broom.
Years ago when I was making a few Besom brooms, mostly to sell at the shows, I tied a lot of them with ash withies, split ash withies, because, you know, with ash dieback, they're just not around now. And an alternative is to split hazel. I'm just going to see if I can still do it or not, but at least I'll take you through the process. Now you will have noticed that when I'm shaving the bark off of this hazel, which is green, I mean obviously cut today, so that will make it easier to work and pliable, that when I was removing the bark, that I keep the knife still and I pull the piece of wood through the knife. That is much safer than doing this, which is dangerous. And obviously you can't control it so well. So what I'm trying to achieve here is to split this hazel straight down the middle. That'll give me two halves, obviously, and then split each half into halves again, and then maybe split those halves into halves again. And that should give me a number of very thin, pliable bonds to tie brooms with. So I've opened it up and I'm trying to steer a straight course down the middle. And of course, nature being slightly devious sometimes, it will want to go off one side or the other. So I have to counteract that by the way that I put pressure on one side or another. And I haven't done this for a long time. In this instance, I think I'm going to achieve that at least. I need to shave the pith line away, that's the centre line, before I can further split it. Here we go for the splitting into four pieces. Anyway, it's nice to see that I've still got the knack after all these decades. I'm pleased with that.